We already know one of the entrants that will be in Sunday afternoon's fifth place game with Boston. Now we got to find ourselves an opponent. Welcome back to our continuing coverage here on WFTDA.TV. Consolation bracket action continues, and boy, have we got a Jim Dandy lined up for you. It's Queen City versus No Coast in the battle. The winner goes on to the fifth place game alongside John Maddening. My name's Muckety Muck. And Queen City, wow, what a story that we've seen here this weekend from the Lake Effect Fury splitting their games yesterday. This team couldn't wait to take to the flat track today. One victory gets them into the fifth place game.
Well, right, and I think really coming into that first game against Toronto, a team they had never beaten, a team they play quite often due to just the proximity of the cities, and getting that first victory just gets that taste in their mouth, ready for more.
Yeah, and another great story that we're following this weekend is No Coast, who notched up a big victory, and I mean huge, 388 over Windy City earlier today to make it into this consolation bracket to get to that fifth place bout. Really, right now, when we look at both these squads, when they entered into this playoff round, regardless of who wins this contest, they're going to finish higher than when they entered in.
And really, No Coast and Queen City, they gave us the Jim Dandiest games.
They did.
The first two games of this tournament were the two best so far, in my opinion, down to the last jams, both of them. And it was just so fun to watch, and I just guarantee this one's going to be fantastic as well.
I couldn't wait for this one to get it launched and underway, because we're going to have a great vocal crown for this one. The folks in Nebraska has been following No Coast this weekend. You can kind of say the quasi-host state, I guess you could say, here of this weekend's activity in Queen City. Of course, the Lake Effect Fury is doing great jobs this weekend as well on the flat track. We are just about ready to go and get underway. Of course, you just witnessed the Boston victory, in which they netted up the victory over Helsinki, 187-165. So Boston, we will see them in tomorrow afternoon's fifth place contest. Who the opponent will be, we will find out here in 60 minutes. And we will check out the lineups here in just a little bit to get you up to date on the colors. Here will be the teal of the Queen City Rollers taking on the white of the Mad Maxines of No Coast. So this is a battle of number 9 versus number 10 as far as the seedings goes, but somebody's going to make a trip to the fifth place bout. It's going to be Librolian of Queen City jamming against Flash Gloria for No Coast as we get underway with this action with the fresh 30 on the clock. And already into the front of the back, it's going to be Librolian here of Queen City.
And that's Megan Harrington, also known as, because the No Coast are going by both names
that's
this
right.
weekend. It's very exciting and different and weird, and I'm curious about it. But Flash Gloria makes it around the outside, but not pack enough to get an additional point. So that's going to be 4-0 in favor of Queen City.
And No Coast, as we said, going with the governmental names throughout the course of the regular season here in the WFTDA for our broadcast purposes here. We will go with the roster that was assigned us here and what we follow via Ringster. So this will be the former names of the of the Mad Maxines of No Coast. So I guess they're never really former. Well, once you go with a derby name, it always sticks with you forever. So in this case, it will be Christy Johnson. Or in this particular case, it's Slam Anderson jamming for No Coast. It's going to be Murphy of Queen City. And Murphy, back-to-back lead jams here for Queen City. And already looks like a use of forearms will be called against Murphy. So now No Coast and Slam Anderson on the power jam.
Slam Anderson, lucky. She just noticed that coming through. Her eyes got big and said, I can do this. I can take it on. We're 4-0, but now it is only the second jam we are on and going on.
As it is Anderson trying to find the inside track. Queen City retaliates with the blocking schema of Bricks Hit House, Black Rock Bruiser, Bikini Wax, and Tamara Schreier. And it will be Slam Anderson all the way through. We'll call off the jam. So a quick strike out of the gates here by No Coast as they notch up 5-4 No Coast leads.
Already a lead change.
Yes.
How exciting.
And I'm sure not the first of many here in this one.
Made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell Skates.
Coming up after this jam, we will check out the lineup here for Queen City, who is the number 9 seed coming into this contest here. They are trailing by 1 point. Anna Soloa, a jammer at the line here for No Coast. And that will be Animaniac. So the 1 point advantage off this power start and immediately off the power jam as Animaniac will be our lead jammer for the Mad Maxines. Murphy back into the mix for Queen City. The advantage right now, 1 point for No Coast. So as Animaniac approaches in turn number 2, trying to find some open wiggle room. Now works her way to the outside. 3-wall in front on the straightaway. Hard pushing charge here by Animaniac around the last line of defense. And Animaniac will get through. 4-point pass here for No Coast.
Murphy having a little more trouble this time. Getting caught up on the inside, getting knocked around, having to recycle all the way to the back of the pack as Animaniac's all the way around again, and another 5 points for Animaniac.
Blocking schema helping out. It is Sormstress, also Ripa, as it will be Animaniac coming up forward for the third scoring pass. Winocos leading by 10 points, 50 seconds into jam number three. Looking for a little bit of outside room as Animaniac will call off the jam, and Nokos will go gliding on in this one. Additional points collected is to the tune of three. 12-0 on this rotation. A Baker's dozen the lead for Nokos, 17-4.
Yeah, her head was on a swivel, just wanting to make sure where Murphy was and just getting that last possible point.
Taking a look at the roster here for Queen City. They will come out with 1027 Bricks Hit House, 153 Low Hits Griffin, 1666 Incinerator, 198 Black Rock Bruiser, 21 is Bikini Wax, 240 is Ivana Layerout, 26 is Murphy, Midnight Maniac Sports 46, Sabrina Schreier is 52, Vagina Warriors 56, 60 is Pepper Sticks, Lebralian is 622, and Tuesday Hula at end number 82 will round out the lineup for the Lake Effect Furies. In jam number four, 15 seconds deep, 13 points the lead for Nokos. With Librarian, Don in the star for Queen City. It's Fancy with the same duties for Nokos. And in front of the pack, after a bit of a scoring brown, it's going to be Librarian here of Queen City.
Yeah, Fancy was having a little more trouble at the back of the pack there. Queen City doing a great job keeping her back there, moving her around, making it tough, but also making her move quite a bit. She's having to force her way through using a lot of strength, but also a lot of just jump back and forth.
As we see a good close watch there of Librarian on the straightaway, already on the second scoring pass here, will accumulate more, a little assistance to the inside, finds a little bit of outside room, assesses the situation, and will call off the jam. Additional points collected to the tune of five, so a quick 10-point strike to counterbalance Nokos's early run, and the lead now only three for Nokos at 17-14, 25-15 left here in the first.
Adam Skates, proud partner of the WFTDA then and now. That's adamskates.com.
Got two sets of rosters for Nokos with governmental and real names. I'm not quite sure who to call for. I got a feeling there's more Nokos fans here, so we will go with the skater names, and we'll look at those here shortly. But right now, a three-point lead for Nokos, as it is Flash Gloria at the line for the Mad Maxines. Low hits Griffin counters for Queen City. Underway with jam number five. If you're just now joining us, this is for entry into tomorrow's fifth place game to take on Boston, who looked really solid against Helsinki just a few moments ago. Nobody with the advantage yet in turn number one. A quick step in front. It is going to be Flash Gloria as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxines.
And the crowd assembled goes wild, as we say.
Yes.
A lot of folks, of course, very close. Lincoln and Omaha very close to each other, so they're able to bring in a lot more fans than a lot of these other teams.
As Gloria makes it through for the Grand Slam, Nokos now extending the margin to 8 points, 40 seconds deep into jam number five. Full complement of blockers in front for the Mad Maxines. Derby Supply penalty box currently unoccupied. Second scoring pass for Flash Gloria. It is 10 so far on this rotation. And now there will be more, a little bit of activity here in turn four. It will send one blocker to the box for Queen City. So a one blocker advantage for the Mad Maxines. Third scoring pass will net a few extra, and it will notch up one non-lead point for Queen City. So 3-1 on that last pass. 13-1 all together in jam number five favors Nokos. It's a 2-1 ratio with Nokos sporting the 30-15 lead.
Yeah, low hits Griffin had that cover in her hand for quite some time, kind of moving it around, and again, a little bit of a magic trick trying to figure that out, trying to keep it out of view of the opposing jam, of the opposing blockers, and eventually did pass it along and did score 1 point for Queen City.
Hocus pocus, flippity flam, erasimataz, and
Alakas
the slam. Anderson jamming here for Nokos. It's Murphy for Queen City. The lead right now 15. Nobody with the advantage yet, as it looks like in the corner. Yes, it is going to be the jammer for Nokos. Slam Anderson sitting in the penalty box, but now a track cut will be assessed here to Murphy. So both jammers currently sitting, or one of them sitting, in the Derby Supply penalty box. Once Murphy approaches and plants, then we will see Slam Anderson emerge. And so now Anderson back into the mix here for Nokos. So a slight brief power jam here for Nokos with a full complement of blockers in front, and it is Slam Anderson out front. She is not the lead.
Already standing, Murphy. 10 seconds to go in her penalty, so she is ready to rejoin her crew. Slam Anderson making her move as much as possible while there is no opposing jammer, and her team can concentrate on helping her out. Oh, but a nice big hit there and number 56, the Jenna Warrior from Queen City.
Queens Hill, you looked really solid in its first play-in game on Friday. Had a tough time against Gotham. Meanwhile, it is Slam Anderson scoring 5 for NoCoast. 45 seconds left in jam number 6. 22 minutes flat left here in the first period. Star pass is collected in, actually held on and maintained by Murphy. So Murphy will be looking to collect up points, but meanwhile it is Slam Anderson with 4 for NoCoast. So the Mad Maxines, as this jam will go its entire 2 minutes here, looking to make a statement early on in the game that determines a opponent for the fifth place game tomorrow against Boston. As Anderson takes a tumble in turn number 3, more whistles assessed will send a blocker of the Mad Maxines to the penalty box. And Anderson will reassess the situation. Might just want to let this one slow on down with under 10 seconds and counting. Little burst of speed in the inside of turn number 2. Now tries to find a little wiggle room to the outside, but nice defensive work there by Queen City's Lambrolian. Or Blackrock Bruiser, I should say. When it was all said and done, a 12-3 rotation. NoCoast rolling along at 42-18.
The Furies really had her number at the end of that jam there. She was a little tired out, and they finally turned it on and fixed it out. Let's go over these Mad Maxines.
Sure, absolutely.
Number 00, Ripa 2C. Number 12, Chu Blockma. Number 152, Anthrax Annie. 2992, Mia Levistich. Number 3, Sly Roller. Number 314, Hulk Tina. 32, Flash Gloria. 34, Slam Anderson. 37, Broken Hearts. Number 5, Storm Stress. Number 565, Fancy. Number 76, Rhinestone Rage. Number 82, Bully McSkater. And number 999, Animaniac.
Into the front, it will be Animaniac as your lead jammer. Right now, second lead jam of the evening for NoCoast's Animaniac, and looking for points to the outside. And those were easy collections right there. So a quick 4 points for NoCoast rolling along here. The ratio, yeah, being extended even further here. 46-18, 20-15 left to go here in the first period of play. More action still coming at you later on tonight. And oh my, we got ourselves the other semifinal contest with Minnesota versus Angel City. That is number 2 versus number 3. Angel City looking to go back to championships as well as Minnesota. Catch that action coming up later on tonight at 8 o'clock Central right here on WFTDA.TV. But we got a great one here. NoCoast leads 46-18, under 20 left here in the first. It's going to be Fancy jamming for NoCoast. It's Low Hits Griffin of Queen City. Big skirmish in front. Nobody with the advantage yet. Full complement of blockers on both sides. And you can see the four walls being set up nicely. Wow, escaping through the pack. Fancy out of nowhere gets in front as your lead jammer for NoCoast.
Yeah, Fancy just bopping and bopping and bopping off to the right, pushing and pushing until there was enough of a hole to get through. Makes it through and gets 5 points and keeps on keeping on as Low Hits Griffin is still making her way through the pack. It's tossed back to the back.
Second scoring pass here for Fancy. Had a solid game against Windy City earlier on with 53 points. That's how they got into this consolation contest. And another 5 collected by Fancy. 10 on this rotation. Looks like NoCoast will keep this one rolling. And why not? Right now, lead midway through this first period of play. And it looks like track cut assessed here to
Low Hits Griffin.
Yeah, Low Hits Griffin will take a seat in the Derby supply penalty box. So numbers becoming an issue now as this jam will be called off by NoCoast.
Perfect time to do so with the jammer just sitting in the box. Start off on a power jam. 3 points scored by NoCoast on that last pass. 18 minutes, 35 seconds to go, and NoCoast leads 59-18.
Mad Maxine's eye-opening victory earlier today, sporting the 300-88 victory over Windy City. Wow, 170-30 was the scoring in that second period of play. Kind of a shocker here at Ralston Arena. Underway with the power start here for Flash Gloria of NoCoast as Low Hits Griffin remains in the Derby supply penalty box, and it will be Flash Gloria as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxine's. One blocker advantage here for NoCoast. And it will add up to some open spaces for Flash Gloria. So right now, the scoring pass collects 5 for Flash Gloria.
And the Furies about to re-enter. 1, then 2. Blocker and jammer back into the thick of it. Both teams are back up to full strength.
And getting through it is Flash Gloria again with another 5-point pass. So it's 10 on this rotation so far. 45 seconds deep into jam number 19. First 12 and a half minutes of play has been dominated here by NoCoast. Third scoring pass forthcoming for Flash Gloria. More whistle success. And it looks like use of the four or no track cut will be the call. as a use of forearms was called on another skater here from No Coast. And we got whistles aplenty here now going against No Coast. So now wide open spaces here for Queen City, as now donning the star, it will be Low Hits Griffin. So now a power jam here and numbers to boot with the 4-2 blocker advantage here for Queen City, trying to capitalize on opportunity.
Minivan situation as all three seats are filled in that No Coast penalty box. Queen City runs roughshod over the remaining two skaters out on the track for No Coast.
Blocking schema out there, Ivana Layer out, also Midnight Maniac, Tabrina Schreier, and Vagina Warrior for Queen City. And that enables Low Hits Griffin to get through for another grand slam. 10 on this rotation so far for Queen City. Looking for the third scoring pass, but sent to the end side. Meanwhile, it is Flash Gloria back into the mix, and these are scoring collections here for No Coast. As you see at the bottom, the point accumulations per jam favors 14-10 in the column of No Coast.
Low Hits Griffin still having trouble at the back of the pack. Jam is over. 4 points scored by both teams on that last pass. That brings No Coast 77, Queen City 32.
Jammer refs have been busy. Let's talk about our officials. Our crew head referee is Lauren Order. It is Alan Yergril as the inside pack referee. Jam refs are Cruel Hand Luke, also Jean-Philippe Amon, Roll Bar, Dizzy Dozer, Jesse Jackass are the outside pack refs, and it's referee, Pantychrist as the referee alternate. Busy day.
All your derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
Back underway with action in Jam 10. No Coast sports the 45-point lead, but Librolian and Queen City wants to counter back. So now with the Lake Effect Furies coming into this postseason as the number 9 seed here in Omaha / Ralston, Nebraska. As it is Librolian coming on through and will collect 5 here for Queen City. 30 seconds deep into Jam number 10.
They dropped Bikini Wax into the box, but that kind of sacrifice bunt is what really helped Librolian get on through. Librolian making another scoring pass now.
And we'll add up, and now it looks like a track cut will be assessed to the blocker here of Queen City. So taking his seat is Bricks Hithouse. That's her first trip to the box. Meanwhile, it is Librolian going to be calling off this jam as it was Slam Anderson fastly approaching the pack. But a good rotation here for Queen City. Lake Effect Fury sport 10 on this rotation. And with just under 15 minutes left here in our first period, score right now, No Coast 77, Queen City 42.
Another star stash situation. We're seeing a lot of these stash situations as opposed to the pass. Not even attempting to make the pass, even looking for on it, just taking off, putting in their hand, waiting and seeing what the opponents are going to do.
Anticipation is half the battle, my friends. It's Animaniac out there for No Coast. It's Murphy for Queen City. No Coast off to a fast start in this one, but Queen City, to their credit, have been chomping away at this deficit. Nobody in the advantage yet until it is Animaniac in front of the pack. Third lead jam for Animaniac here for the Mad Max scenes. Meanwhile, it is Murphy trying to bust on through. Wow, wide open there for Animaniac, who nets 5 for No Coast. Finally, it is Murphy escaping from the pack. Numbers becoming a factor again for Queen City as there's 2 blockers, now 3 in the Derby Supply penalty box. And numbers really starting to favor No Coast as Animaniac will notch up another 5. We'll get 10 on this rotation here. And we will have ourselves an official timeout with 13:41 left to go here in our first period of play. No Coast, the Mad Maxine sport the 82-42 lead.
Just as Bricks Hithouse was standing up and just ready to move out, Bikini Wax and Ivana Lear out just zoomed on in to take her place.
Mm-hmm.
Plus 1 in that Derby Supply penalty box.
Queen City takes this time out, their first time out in this one. You get a good look at the Lake Effect Furies. And, of course, all this action you're watching this weekend, courtesy of Blaze Stream Media. They've done fantastic production work here this weekend. And, of course, it's being made in part by some of our great sponsors that are bringing forth this great action. John, let's give a little sugar to one of them.
Well, for instance, Sin City Skates, the first, the best, happy to fix the rest. That's SinCitySkates.com.
That's John Maddening. My name's Muckety Muck. We're so happy that you're along for the ride here on WFTDA.TV. course, we always have an abundance of stats in front of us here. And right now, as we look at our little computer monitors here, John, it looks like a lot of things in the favor of Nokos, especially when it comes to lead jams.
Animaniac, 100% lead jam status, 3 for 3. She's not been to the box yet, scored 25 points. No points scored against her.
Adds up to this 86-42 advantage when you take all things into consideration. It is fancy jamming for Nokos Librolian for Queen City. As Nokos looking to make a statement here on a Saturday, they can notch up 2 solid wins and a trip to the fifth place mount. And into the front of the pack, it will be Fancy as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxines. Librolian still hemmed up on the straightaway, trying to make it through on the initial pass. These are a scoring pass here for Fancy. And taking a tumble there was Fancy, and it looks like the black box will be assessed here to Fancy. So now opportunity with Librolian, who got through on the initial pass. These are 4 points.
Yeah, that was actually, that brought Fancy up to a 67% lead jam percentage, but she just lost it as she sat down in that Derby Supply penalty box. Jam's going to go for an additional 1:07 as Librolian approaches the back of the pack. And nails that apex jump. I was not sure whether she was going to be able to do that. That was fantastic.
Everybody kind of had a mini heart attack on that one, but that one stuck through. It's 10 so far on this rotation and this power jam here for Queen City. Full complement of blockers to boot, but yeah, Fancy footwork will net you 5 every time as Librolian here on the 3rd scoring pass as Fancy emerges from the Derby Supply penalty box for Nokos. So the power jam comes to its conclusion as Librolian trying to push through tough wall in front. Whistles being assessed, and it looks like it will be a use of a forearms being called here against Fancy. So back-to-back power jams in this rotation for Queen City.
Yeah, just out of the box. Not even a full rotation around the track yet, and it gets called on an additional penalty, a forearm, taking a seat along now with her pivot. Not a good move for Nokos right now. Number 3, Sly Roller, again sitting right next to Fancy in that Derby Supply penalty box.
We've seen all kinds of fancy footwork here by Librolian in this rotation, which reaches its conclusion. When it was all said and done, looks like an additional 5 points will be notched up by Queen City. Nokos did notch up 2 points. So, when it was all said and done, it looks like 88-57 is going to be our score. Queen City knocking at the door with the power start.
11:23 to go in this first half of play. Performance plates for the modern and derby game, Powerdyne. Powerdyne is another proud sponsor of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
Want to talk to us? The way to do so, talk to WFTDA. Want to hear and see what you think about our upcoming matchups later on tonight and who you think is going to win the whole weekend. It is Low Hits Griffin on the power start for Queen City. It is Fancy back into the mix, fresh from the penalty box for Nokos. So the power jam did seize up some major opportunity and momentum, and it will add up to a Low Hits Griffin. Lead jam here for Queen City. Fancy gives close chase and escapes from the pack as well. But upcoming here, it is Low Hits Griffin. Meanwhile, tough defense up front by Queen City as Low Hits Griffin approaches and knocks Fancy out of play. And in the process, Low Hits Griffin will get through for the grand slam. And this one gets tightened up even tighter, 26 points right now the deficit. Fancy now trying to escape from the pack as more whistles will be assessed. A lot of chaos here in the straightaway as Low Hits Griffin does get on through for another scoring pass. And this one will be to the tune of 4 points. So 9 on the strike right now for Low Hits Griffin.
It was Ivana Leo out who got a low block penalty, taking out Fancy. That was 9 points scored by Queen City that last jam, bringing them up to 66. Nokos still sitting pretty at 88 with just under 10 minutes to go in the first half.
Taking a look at the penalties so far, a little bit heavy on the side of Queen City. A couple of skaters with 2 infractions apiece with Wax Layer out, Murphy, and Vagina Warrior. On the other side of the column, we have a couple of skaters with 2, probably the 2 most important ones, though, with a pair of infractions, power jams against Nokos in that first couple of minutes or a few minutes ago, led up to this Queen City charge, which continues now with Murphy as your lead jammer for the Lake Effect Furies.
Followed very closely by Flash Gloria, though less than a quarter of a track behind her. Murphy's probably just going to hit it and quit it here. Does not. Flash Gloria laps her, picking up 4 points. Murphy picks up the 4 as well. is trying to decide whether to call it off, does call it off after getting confirmation from her coach.
Well, you got to call it off. You only had one blocker out there supporting you, so you had no other option, as NoCoast sported three out there at that time. Good time to call a timeout, says NoCoast. And we will take a break here with 8:49 left to go in our first period of play. The winner of this one goes on to the fifth-place bout to take on Boston. Right now, your score, NoCoast 92, Queen City 70.
Pretty even in terms of penalties, though. Yes. 12 for Queen City. 13 for NoCoast, as the score is now 70-92. Both teams scored 4 points that last jam. The four-jammer rotation for NoCoast: Flash Gloria, Slam Anderson, Fancy, and Animaniac, up against the three-jammer rotation from Queen City: Librarian, Low Hits Griffin, and Murphy.
Get a good look of the squad from Lincoln, Nebraska, coming into this one as the number 10 seed, right on the bubble, right on the edge of the WFTDA Division I rankings. And now all of a sudden we see them really making a hard charge, and this weekend's going to benefit them, no doubt. Depending on the finish here, they can kind of inch up the D1 rankings, or they can make a huge jump. Both these squads can do a lot of damage here in these D1 rankings as a result of their weekend play.
Yeah, Librarian is up for Queen City. We're in this next jam. She has a 50% lead jam percentage. She's picked up 39 points for Queen City. And the other two jammers, Lois Griffin and Murphy, have picked up a total of 31. Librarian is actually also the only Queen City jammer with a positive points differential. Mm. 33 points scored as opposed to points scored on her. Over on the NoCoast side, it looks like we have number 999, Anna Maniac, joining. She has scored 25 points so far, 25 unanswered points. And she has a 75% lead jam percentage as we begin jam 15 of this game in just a few minutes.
Fast-paced action here so far. This time's been flying by here in this consolation action. And we know with this raucous crowd that's here at Ralston Arena, we knew that this one was going to be a special one. It's been a fun one here on WFTDA.TV. Thank you so much for joining us here on our coverage. Back underway with the clock starting 8:50 and counting left here in this first period of play. It is Librarian for Queen City being sent to the outside. And in front, Azure Lee Jammer. It's going to be Animaniac for the NoCoast Mad Maxines.
A very nice try there by Trabrina Schreier, trying to push in Animaniac. It just did not work. Able to recover and get lead jam, get 4 points, call it off. Very textbook.
We love the textbook style of derby here. That's usually going to equal up to a W in your column, and we've seen some great victories here. We'll recap your action here at the conclusion of this next jam, but we've had some real doozies as this day has progressed. Some eye-openers, some close contests. You could say we also saw a very dominant performance by the top seed, but a spirited effort by the team that came in at number 4. We'll recap your scores after jam number 16. It's going to be Slam Anderson donning the star for NoCoast. It's Low Hits Griffin for Queen City, and it looks like multiplayer block is going to be called here against Queen City, but in the process, it is Slam Anderson as your lead jammer for NoCoast. Back-to-back lead jams for the Mad Maxines.
Ivana Layer out, taking the brunt of that and having to take a seat. 5 points scored by NoCoast there. Slam Anderson as Bricks Hithouse joins in the Derby Supply penalty box.
4-2 pack advantage here for the Mad Maxines as Anderson on the second scoring pass makes that one through relatively easily, and it's now 10 on this rotation for NoCoast. 1:21 left to go in jam number 16. 7:15 left to go in the first period of play. NoCoast was being stymied for a while in the scoring column. Now they're back on their path to a solid finish. So it'll be another collection of points, 14 on this rotation for Slam Anderson. NoCoast leads this one now by 40, 110-7.
And that's Low Hits Griffin yet again in the middle of the jam, taking off the star, trying to decide whether she's going to pass it off, deciding to make her move, get through, and to put it back on.
Griffin with 23 points right now, second in scoring next to Librarian's 39. Other side of the ledger right now is points, pretty even distribution, you'd say. We'll take a look at our stats at halftime, give you the full report. Right now it is Flash Gloria as your lead jammer for NoCoast. Murphy dons the star for Queen City. So now with Flash Gloria, full complement of blockers in front to help out the situation in turn number 1. Pushing. Now 3-1 in front, trying to slow down the progress. But nice footwork gets her around, and Flash Gloria will collect the full 5 here for NoCoast.
5-0 so far as Murphy's making her move here. Getting run right into those no-coast blockers. Having to recycle all the way to the back of pack once again.
Gloria with a pirouette. Nicely done there as Gloria now has 10 on this rotation. 50 points. Now the lead here for the Mad Maxines. Star pass now handed off here to Brina Schreier, who now will put the jammer cap on top. Meanwhile, Flash Gloria. We'll see some whistles here. It looks like some late whistles as this jam is being called off. 3 points, three additional points collected by the Mad Maxines. And that will be a 13-0 jam for No Coast, making our score 123-70. No Coast with the advantage, 5.5 minutes left here in the first.
Bricks Hithouse and Ivana Layer out, both in that Derby Supply penalty box, both now with 4 box trips. That's more than half of their allotted number already. With still with 5 minutes to go in the first half, they've really got to watch themselves for the rest of this game.
And for both these squads making it to this portion of the consolation bracket, clean play is what's got them here. Not a lot of penalties for both the jammers and the blockers. It's uncharacteristically high here for Queen City in this contest. Librelian is your lead jammer, however, for the Lake Effect Furies. And the apex jump is stuck perfectly, and it will be a 4-point pass. Meanwhile, 4 collected by Animaniacs. So a 4-4 split them up here between both squads. Both skaters looking for their second scoring pass. Librelian and will be hemmed into the back, and that will allow Animaniac to get on through. So right now it's 8 notched up here by No Coast.
Yeah, Animaniac almost just kind of shook her head in amazement after seeing that apex jump by Librelian, and then she just sailed through easily, and now an additional 3 times. So that brings No Coast up to 13 points. Queen City at 4 for this jam.
That was a huge gamble there by getting lead jam and keeping that one going, and it came back to haunt Queen City as additional points were collected by the Mad Maxine. So when it was all said and done, 13-7 was the strike there by No Coast. So doing some damage there when they were not the lead is what the Mad Maxines did.
That means it's 136 for No Coast, 77 for Queen City with just under 4 minutes to go. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad. S1Helmets.com.
Slam Anderson dons the star for No Coast. It's Low Hits Griffin for Queen City. In jam number 19, we see Slam Anderson to the front of the pack. Right now, third in scoring with 31 points for the Mad Maxines. But it's been a solid team effort so far for No Coast, just like they did earlier today against Windy City. Low Hits Griffin still trying to get through on the initial pass. Scoring pass here for Anderson with 1 to beat the pivot and gets on around. Midnight Maniac and will collect all 5 here for No Coast.
Low Hits Griffin still having some trouble. Sleeton slowed down. 3 blockers in front of her. The fourth moves back to the back. And allowing Slam Anderson to get on through once again for an additional 5 points for No Coast. Really on a tear these last few jams.
Rip has been solid out there, as well as Sly Roller and a host of others, making those wide open spaces happen for Slam Anderson and others. This is the third scoring pass for Anderson on the straightaway. At the inside line and got on through. It is 15 so far on this rotation. Under a minute left to go in jam 19. 2:48 left to go in the first period of play. Coming up on the 4th scoring pass, looking for assistance up front, 3 wall in front by the Lake Effect Furies. Anderson taking her time, working her way, dancing her way around turn number 2. Now with a little bit of assistance there and by Rippa, and it will lead into some points for Slam Anderson. Another grand slam collected. It's 19-20, count it so far for No Coast.
An additional No Coast player now to the box. That's number 0-0, Rippa 2C. Going to be taking a seat. That brings up the Mad Maxines to 17 penalties so far this game, with the Lake Effect Furies at 21. So still pretty close in that, but definitely No Coast being able to capitalize on those penalties. Especially because Queen City's penalties are more. Well, actually, no, I take that back entirely. Queen City has 3 jammer penalties, whereas No Coast has 4. Murphy has 2 with Low Hits Griffin having 1. Over on the No Coast side, Beth Kemp, that's number 565, also known as Fancy, having 2. with number 34, Slam Anderson, and Flash Gloria also with one each.
4-3 pack advantage here for Queen City adds up to lead jam for Murphy for Queen City. So now looking to pick up some much-needed points very deep into this first period of play. Flash Gloria of No Coast also escapes from the pack as well as Murphy looks to do a little damage to the outside, assesses the situation, and calls off the jam as Flash Gloria was approaching quickly. It will be four notched up here by Queen City. Nothing accumulated by No Coast, so trying to chip away as time winds down. You want to have a couple of strong jams in this first period of play. And a timeout will be taken here with 57 seconds left to go in our first period of play. And actually, we're going to switch this over. It looks to a official review being called here by No Coast. So we will have a stop in the action, and we will reset ourselves for more derby action here shortly.
We have been together for 10 years defining our sport with real, strong, athletic players, teams, and officials. It is revolutionaries like you that bring us all together. Happy anniversary, everyone. Here's to more years of international roller derby play as the 10-year anniversary of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
Happy anniversary, baby. Got you on my mind. Here's how your Saturday has looked so far here. As?
No Coast is challenging the number of points given on the last pass.
All right.
I will always shush my
Lauren
mouth.
Order.
Yes. She's got the mic, folks, and she supersedes all. Your scores from Saturday so far as we check over this official review. If you're just now joining us, Toronto with a huge victory over Boston earlier today. Or I'm sorry, that was not that way. I got to recheck my scores. Actually, it was No Coast over Windy City 388. Gotham over Montreal 259-21. Boston over Helsinki 187-65. And right now we stand at 157-81. Queen City on top in this contest. 212-127. I juxtaposed, and I actually almost had a palindrome there. 212-127 was that victory that Boston had over Toronto earlier today. That's why I write it in pencil, not in magic marker. You can always make mistakes, but you can always change and correct it.
You can see crew head referee Lauren Order listening to both coaches.
We await here. We will find out shortly, and here is the official word.
On No Coast official review, the points will stand. Queen City has also requested an official review of a possible out-of-bounds block that happened near turn one.
So just like that, we flip the graphics and we move the yellow bar to the other side, as the official review will now be taken here by Queen City.
Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable, and customizable carbon fiber boots from Bont. You can find them at bont.com.
See, 10 years of action here in the WFTDA, and that's helped out our presentation here on WFTDA.tv. A push of the button changes the graphics, and we switch it from one side to the other. That's technology, my friends. Evolution.
On Queen City's side, Librolian leads right now with 46 points. Low hits Griffin with 24. And Murphy with 11. Over on the side of No Coast, number 34, Slam Anderson leads with 52 points. Following her is number 32, Flash Gloria with 48. Number 999, that's Animaniac with 42. And rolling on is Fancy with 15 points.
Of course, the winner of this squad plays tomorrow. And that one's going to be a fun one as we take a look at our bracket, as we will pencil in Boston competing in that fifth place game tomorrow. We have some games already lined up for tomorrow morning, as we will see Windy City taking on Toronto. That one will be taking place tomorrow at 10 a.m. Central.
It's a great pencil you have there that you're...
The folks at home will know the truth
when they come
back to the announcer cam here shortly.
Oh, boy. This is a.
Don't ever say I try to pull the wool over anybody's eyes. Dude.
Are you a teacher in real life? Because that's a lot of red pen usage,
used
my friend.
Used to be.
Uh-huh.
All caps underlined. Used to be. Well, this official review continues on, being launched here by Queen City. Of course, it's been a fun weekend here at Ralston Arena. Of course, we thank the Omaha Roller Girls who've been so fantastic in hosting, and we knew it was going to be that way because they always put on top-notch local events here in the Omaha area, but we knew coming into a brand-new facility, and yes, this has been great as you've been watching the action on WFTDA.TV. Beautiful-looking track, beautiful-looking facility. The seat's about 4,000. I got a feeling when we reach our championship rounds tomorrow, this place will be going bonkers.
The International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships bring together the most talented skaters and teams in the WFTDA. You can join us November 6th to 8th for the 2015 International WFTDA Championships hosted by the Minnesota Roller Girls. And I, of course, would invite everyone to come up to the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium to see that live. You got to be at the Roy. You got to see a game at the Roy sometime in your life if you're a fan of this sport. And if you can't make it, of course, there is WFTDA.TV. And, of course, on Sunday, ESPN3 will be carrying the final games. But we would love to have you up in St. Paul. We guarantee a fun time.
Absolutely.
For everyone who attends.
And if you weren't sure if you could get ESPN3 or not on your local cable provider, keep in mind there are numerous resources for you to refer to. You'll just have to go to WFTDA.TV. They will keep you up to date on which cable providers and which systems and which formats you can use to watch that action. So let's hear our official review and the result.
After discussion, no coast blocker White 3-7 will start in the penalty box on an out-of-bounds block.
All right, so that is a bonus for Queen City there. They retain their official review. Granted, it's only 57 seconds remaining in this game. But with a definite advantage right here as Animaniac takes the Fast Girl start line up against number 622, Librolium for Queen City. No Coast 157, Queen City 81 with 57 seconds to go on the period clock.
So underway with jam number 21. Queen City trying to hold close here to No Coast. No Coast wanting to make this one a 2-1 ratio. Librolian in front as your lead jammer for Queen City, but also escaping from the pack is Animaniac of No Coast. So the pace starting to pick up here in the latter stretches of the first period of play as Librolian approaches, trying to get around the two wall. Meanwhile, Animaniac has her mind set on collecting points as well, but it will be a four spot sported by Queen City. Holding tight to this one as time winds down. And right now we are seeing our score set at 157 to 85 as the clock counts down, 15 seconds and counting left here in the first period of play.
Oh, and we're calling for an official review. Mine, Queen City here.
All right.
We're gonna exercise an official review. It might be about we don't know whether or not the jammer was wearing two skates. Or
so 10 seconds left.
Official review as a timeout.
There we go. It was Justice Feelgood Marshall who always came up with the greatest fake official reviews.
Is that right?
And we wanted to decide who is where we're going after the game.
Important matters.
We think that the refs really should buy the first round, et cetera.
Priorities.
But now with a rule clarification, you don't actually have to come up with a rule and with a reason for an official review anymore. All you have to do is say you're going to use it as your timeout, and that was great for Queen City, who has now used it two in a row. So they get basically a free timeout here.
I think finding out who buys the first round is a legitimate excuse to use an official review. I find nothing wrong with that whatsoever.
157 to 85 in favor of No Coast. 10 seconds on the period clock, of course, for you, all of you experts back home. You know that it can go for up to 2 full minutes after that whistle blows. We are off. Oh, and a nice move by Librolian there.
Yeah, really playing to the strength in numbers in front there. It was Queen City as the period clock expires. Scoring pass here for Librolian and up on one skate and through. So already 5 out of the gates quickly here for Queen City. So looking to do quick work in short order. Meanwhile, it will be forearms assessed to a pair of Queen City blockers. So now the numbers starting to even out a little bit. Librolian through for a second scoring pass, this time notching up 4. So it's 9 on this rotation so far.
Yeah, it was actually very lucky that Librolian did not see her coach telling her to call it off, as she just saw that there was a big blocker switch in the penalty box there. as two Lake Effect Furies go in and two NoCo skaters came out.
Meanwhile, scoring passes being notched up by Flash Gloria as well, as Lyralian looking for the third scoring pass. Another five collected here by NoCo. So once again, they're turning the non-leads into their favor as Lyralian gets through for another scoring pass. Back and forth scoring with 50 seconds left to go in the jam clock, and Lyralian and Queen City is going to keep this one rolling on.
Yeah, 4-4 to 4-4 to 4, it seems. Continuing over and over again, they're matching point for point, but oh, not this time. It is exactly 17-17 jam there for that final jam of the first half. NoCo leads 174 to Queen City, just passing the century mark at 102.
Very dominant performance here by NoCo so far, with a 174 sported on the scoreboard right now here at intermission. But I think Queen City's got to feel pretty good, though. A nice roll of points at the latter stretches of that first half of play narrows down the differential a little bit. They're going to be going into the intermission, the locker rooms, with a 72-point advantage as you get a look at the whiteboard there. And a little more penalties on the side, especially with the one skater with five trips to the box for Queen City. But taking a look, that is Ivana Layer out with five trips to the box right now. So Queen City still within reach in this one, being down by 72 points. And, of course, wanting the cleanup of the play is the prerogative here in the second period.
Yeah, you know, they've had a little penalty trouble, but it's, again, pretty even. 23 trips to the box for Queen City and 25 for No Coast. So pretty even over on the side of jammer penalties. Again, Murphy with two, one for Low Hits Griffin, and a total of four over there for No Coast as well. Lyralian really just leading the jammers right now with 67 points. And then number 32, Flash Gloria, with 65 on the side of the No Coast skaters. But it's 174 to 102. We'll be back in about 11 minutes to finish out this game as Minnesota takes the track for their warm-ups.
Yeah, stay with us right here on WFTDA.TV. And welcome back to Ralston Arena as we get ready to go and getting underway with our second period of play. Your score here at halftime, No Coast Mad Maxines lead Queen City Lake Effect Furies 174 to 102 alongside John Madden. My name's Muckety Muck. Some interesting strategies we saw in our first period of play, specifically by Queen City when their jammer would get lead, that they kept the jammer going. No Coast started accumulating those non-lead points, if not mistaken, at least in the 30s altogether in non-lead points notched up here by Don Coast, and that's kind of stretched open this differential. So rolling the dice a little bit was Queen City in that first period of play.
Now we're also looking at Queen City here. 67 points for Lyralian, 24 for Low Hits Griffin, 11 for Murphy. But Lyralian is the only one with a positive points differential. Right. That means she's scored more points than the team, than the opposing jammer. Negative points differentials for both Low Hits Griffin with a negative 55, Murphy with a negative 44 over on the side of No Coast. You can see by the score, only one Fancy with a negative points differential. It's 19, but we had Animaniac with 31, Slam Anderson with 39, and Flash Gloria with 21. Just under a minute to go in halftime as we begin this second half of this game.
And, of course, one thing we're keeping close eye on as well is the penalty count, and especially on the side of Queen City. Right now, Ivana Layer out with five trips to the Derby Supply penalty box in that first period of play. Bricks Hit House with four. So those are two stats to keep close watch here in the second period of play. And you get the overall view from our whiteboard there at mid-track. On the other side of the line for No Coast, not too much to be concerned about. Andrea Tarnick with four trips to the box and really a smattering of skaters with three trips. So overall, a cleaner period of play by No Coast in that first.
Lyralian lining up on the Fast Girl start line up against number 32. That is Flash Gloria for No Coast. 5 seconds is called and we are off.
And keep in mind, the winner of this contest faces Boston in our fifth place game tomorrow, while the one that suffers defeat takes on Helsinki. Already immediately off the get-go in the early stages of our second period of play, it's going to be Lyralian as your lead jammer for a Queen City. So full complement of blockers in front as Flash Gloria takes a tumble, and already five on the board here for Lyralian.
I know Queen City going in back, wanted to come out strong in this first half. It's not an insurmountable lead by any stretch of the imagination, and already 5-0. already on a second scoring pass, whereas Flash Gloria has yet to make it through. Now, I take that back. Now she has. She's made it through on her initial pass and re-adds the helmet cover as Librelian picks up an additional five for a 10-point, 10-0 jam, bringing Queen City up to 112, No Coast at 174.
So fast start out of the gates there for Queen City. They come into this playoff round as the number 9 seed. No Coast was number 10, as we've made mention. They are both going to, whether they win or lose this contest here specifically, they will both finish in a higher placement than when they came into this weekend. So both teams definitely trending up. It's Slam Anderson donning the star for No Coast. Ivana Layer out for Queen City, and it will be Slam Anderson as your lead jammer for No Coast.
Slam Anderson already halfway around the track, ready to make her initial scoring pass here. As Ivana Layer out. Ooh, almost gets through, but takes a bit of a tumble down to her knees. Has to recycle to the back of the pack.
Already five sported by Anderson, and the first jam out of the gates for Ivana Layer out. So switching up the jammer rotation a little bit, and we'll see how this plays into their effect, the Lake of Fury effect, as this contest goes on. Meanwhile, second scoring pass for Anderson. Taking a tumble, it looks like the back block will be assessed here, so Anderson will have to take a seat. And now an opportunity for Ivana Layerout and Queen City.
Unfortunately for Queen City, though, they are down by one blocker right now. They make the star pass over to number 60, that's Pepper Sticks. But they only have three blockers out on the pack right now.
Yes, Lake Effect Furies did this very, very effectively with the star passes to Sticks earlier on in this tournament. So let's see if they can flip the switch and get some points here. As Pepper Sticks on the straightaway, trying to get around the full wall of No Coast. Nice defensive work up front. Three blockers in front assisting Pepper Sticks, that being Layer Out, also Vagina Warrior, and Tuesday Hula. This power jam will reach its conclusion, so nice work defensively here by No Coast on the power jam kill. As Slam Anderson forced to the inside, back into the mix. Meanwhile, Pepper Sticks, who received the star, still trying to get on through. 25 seconds left in jam number 2. We're already 3 minutes deep into the second period. In on through, 4 points. It will be Slam Anderson notching up the grand slam. Meanwhile, Pepper Sticks looking 4 points down the stretch with the pivot to get around and beat. One-on-one matchup, and finally escaping through, it will be Pepper Sticks notching up the grand slam herself. So 5-5 for both squads. Actually, No Coast has also got another 5 or 4 off of that pass by Slam Anderson. So when it was all said and done, it's actually going to be 14 notched up here by No Coast. So Queen City with the advantage could not quite capitalize. Good defense by No Coast, and they gained some points in the process. So right now, 26-30 left here in the second. 188 for No Coast. It's 117 for Queen City.
Jackson Skates, more bang for your buck. You can see that. You can meet them at adam.com. Adamskates.com. Adamskates.com.
With jam number 3 underway with Librelian for Queen City, it's Animaniac for No Coast. Full complement of blockers on both sides of the ledger. Oh, nice move to the inside. It will be Librelian as your lead jammer for Queen City. Meanwhile, whistles being assessed as it will send one blocker to the box here for the Mad Maxines. It is Librelian as your lead jammer looking to post up points. Animaniac does escape from the pack. We'll see if Librelian Queen City wants to keep this one rolling. And yes, just like we saw in the first period of play, they're going to keep this jam a moving. Meanwhile, it will be a track cut assisted and assessed to Animaniac. So this time the gamble pays off, and Librelian now with the power jam for Queen City.
Again, with Bully McSkater in the penalty box, as well as number 21, Bikini Wax, and now joined by Bricks Hithouse again. Both players, both teams just bleeding players out there. That's Bricks Hithouse's sixth trip to the box. Bikini Wax with 4.
I will say that I was very, very nervous that Librelian Queen City was going to keep this jam alive as Animaniac was posting points. But now it's paying out to their advantage as they've got a 14-0 roll going on here and still add more to the column as Librelian will not jump the grand slam. It's 19 on this rotation for the Lake Effect Furies. Meanwhile, Animaniac back into the mix. More whistles assessed. Looks like a track cut will be assessed to one blocker of Queen City. And another scoring pass here for Librelian. With 30 seconds left to go in jam number 3, nets up 4 points here for Librelian. A little bit of drama here by Queen City, but it actually paid off to their advantage that timeout. 23-4 is what the tally is going to be in favor of Queen City on that rotation. And chomping at the bit and narrowing this deficit now down to 52 points.
Yeah, a nice big move there by Queen City to Brina Shire in the Derby Supply penalty box. Second half, so far, Queen City has scored 38 points to No Coast's 18 points. So if Queen City can keep this momentum going, they definitely have a shot at this.
That 23-point punch really, really played into their favor. It's going to be Murphy donning the star for Queen City. It's Flash Gloria from No Coast. Reaching 24 minutes left to go here in regulation, and Flash Gloria is going to be your lead jammer for No Coast. Meanwhile, it is Murphy also escaping the pack as well. Pace picketing up with the full complement of blockers in front. A foot race to the turn number two, and it will be Flash Gloria weaving her way through, and nicely done, and we'll get on through with a four-point strike. Meanwhile, Murphy collecting points as well. Flash Gloria and No Coast electing to keep this one a going, and now it's going to pay off to their advantage as the back block will be assessed to Murphy, and our power jam here for Flash Gloria and No Coast.
Yeah, that was a definite gamble on the part of Flash Gloria, not calling it off there when Murphy had made it halfway through. She decides not to call it off, and it totally worked out for him.
Hey, it's conversely what we saw on our last rotation. This time it winds the way here to the Mad Maxines, as Gloria now has additional points on this rotation. We'll say 9 so far on this power jam. As Gloria's forced to the outside on the back straightaway, now finds some inside room and will call off the jam. Another 5 points notched up by No Coast. 3 was gained by Queen City as well.
So that is No Coast at 206, passing the double century mark. Queen City at 143 with 22 minutes, 44 seconds to go in this game. Get your league sponsored for product discounts by Fast Girl Skates. You can email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com. That is fastgirlskates.com.
And at the Fast Girl start line, it is going to be Animaniac as the Soul Jammer out there donning the star as Murphy awaits to re-enter play from the Derby Supply penalty box. And to the front of the back, it's going to be Slam Anderson as your lead jammer. Meanwhile, star pass being made here to Bikini Wax of Queen City.
Attempting at least. I don't see it in her hands
not yet. Back hit that star so well that it kind of crossed us here as Slam Anderson will be assessed the back block penalty in that kerfuffle. And Murphy now
retains the star.
So now the power jam here for Queen City. 40 seconds deep into jam number 5. This one's been everything and advertised so far as Queen City is looking to cinch up this differential with the power jam. Full complement of blockers in front for the Mad Maxines, however. As it is Murphy trying to bust the way on through in turn number 1. Nice defense with the 3-wall up front, taking a tumble. As it is Murphy trying to inch forward. Now it is Slam Anderson, fresh from the box, back into the mix and scoring points to the tune of 4. 45 seconds deep into the jam, or I should say left in this jam. Time now starting to become a factor here in this contest. We still got a lot of clock time, but with the pace that we've seen here in this contest, time flies by in a hurry. More points collected here by Slam Anderson. 9 so far in this rotation. Murphy still trying to get on through. And Slam Anderson with another scoring pass. This time, the Grand Slam collected. No Coast rolling up the points as they now got the 220 to 143 edge with 24, or I should say a 20 under 20 seconds left to go in jam number 5.
Two blockers in the box for No Coast right now, 1 for Queen City.
And as time winds down here in jam number 5, a message sent by No Coast. You might be trying to cinch up this differential, but we can come and really tie a nice surge of our own.
A 24-point jam there by No Coast, answered with 5 points from Queen City. That brings No Coast up to 230 points. Queen City at 148 with just over 20 minutes to go in this game.
Boston awaits in the wings for the winner of this competition in the fifth place bout that takes place tomorrow afternoon. Of course, our coverage tomorrow morning begins at 10 a.m. with a ninth place game between Windy City and Toronto. In front, as your lead jammer, it's going to be Animaniac for No Coast. And once again, seizing advantage of opportunity with the numbers in play, it is the Mad Maxines, as it will be Animaniacs. Nice footwork to the outside and collects up the grand slam here for No Coast. As Animaniac approaches the pack, looking for the second scoring pass, with Winkler, also Ethon, Kane, and Kemp in front, leading down the charge, and the blocking has been solid here for the Mad Maxines. Another five collected here by Animaniac. Third scoring pass forthcoming, 40 seconds deep into the jam, under 20 left to go in regulation. Bodies go a-tumbling in turn number three, but escaping through it is Animaniac. We will call it 15 on this rotation so far. Down to a minute left in jam number six. Meanwhile, sent to the outside is Savannah Layerout, who dons the star right now. Four scoring pass here for Animaniac around the two wall. A little bit of wiggle room, gets on through, and now it's 20, notched up here by No Coast. A huge surge of points in the last 5 minutes of play. So now Animaniacs here on the fifth scoring pass to the inside. Now looks for some room in turn number two. Takes a tumble. Nice defense. But it will be Animaniacs getting on through, and we'll call it off. My, oh, my. And in the process, in that last rotation already, Queen City's Bricks Hit House has found out of this contest here. So a double whammy there, as we saw 24 points collected by No Coast and an imperative key component of the blocking schema eliminated for Queen City.
And that brings Queen City down to only 11 players out here. They are going to start getting tired. They have 18 minutes to go in this game. No Coast still with every single one of their players out there. The most penalties we have, number 00, that's Ripa 2C, with four trips to the box. And over on Queen City, Ivana Layerout also with five, getting close herself.
62-point roll here for No Coast in the last three rotations. They're going to look to add on more as it's Flash Gloria as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxines. Full complement of blockers from both sides. Meanwhile, it is Librolian escaping from the pack as well. She will lose a blocker in the process, but it will be points notched up here by the Mad Maxines to the tune of four. Makes the score 258 for No Coast, 148 for Queen City, 17-20 left here in the first, or in the second.
And that's Vigena Warrior taking a seat for Queen City as well. That is her fourth penalty.
On the
looks like when we're looking at points here, Animaniac leading right now with 70 points for No Coast. I'm sorry, Slam Anderson leading with 90 points, Animaniac with 70 over on Queen City's side. Librolian with an even 100. As Low Hits Griffin takes the jammer star for Queen City.
She has 14 or 24 in this contest. Slam Anderson sports 90 in this game. And it will be Slam Anderson as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxines. Wanting to make a track into the fifth place game. Keep this pace going, they'll get there easily. Taking on Boston tomorrow. As, hop, skip, and a jump, but a tough, tough fall in the process. But it will be points to the tune of five collected by Slam Anderson, and that makes this Partisan Crown here from Nebraska very, very happy.
She may have slid down and taken a tumble, but she nailed the landing, and that's all that matters.
45 seconds deep into the jam. Anderson for the second scoring pass. Won't be quite as easy this time with the three wall in front. And now the star pass has been made here to Pepper Sticks. We saw this earlier on in this contest and played out to great effect. And speaking of that effect, Apex jump was launched but was not quite there and will not be any points in the process as the jam was called off. 7 points notched up by No Coast on that rotation, making our score now 265 for the Mad Maxines. Queen City sports 148.
Yeah, unfortunately for Pepper Sticks and the Queen City team, that fourth whistle blew while she was in the air. She was not able to get any of those points that she was passing right at that point. You know you don't want to miss a minute of championships. You can get your WFTDA.TV watch pass now for only $22.50. Live it or stream it live on WFTDA.TV.
With jam number nine underway with Animaniac jamming for No Coast, it's Librolian of Queen City. Multiplayer block called against Queen City. We'll send one blocker to the box. Nobody with the advantage yet until now, as Animaniac will be your lead jammer. So a pair of blockers now going to the Derby Supply penalty box. One also reemerges from the penalty box. So it's still a one blocker advantage for a No Coast.
Midnight Maniac and Bikini Wax both now in that penalty box.
Yes, and those are close numbers to watch here for Queen City, especially after losing Bricks Hithouse in this contest. 5-9 stump by Animaniac, pushing the score now to 270 to 148 midway through the second period of play. Another blocker going to the box here for Queen City. Full Derby Supply penalty box for the Lake Effect Furies. And now Animaniac and Oakcoast capitalizing on the numbers. Midway through jam number five, it is going to be another 5-4 Animaniac.
That is Librolian, actually, who went to the penalty box there for Queen City. She still has the helmet cover in her hand.
And as this jam is called off by Animaniac, 15 points here for No Coast. A nice working machine from Lincoln is what we're seeing here in this second period of play. 280 to 148. No Coast with the advantage with a flat 14 left to go in regulation.
Queen City was really coming from behind. They could have getting very close, but now No Coast nearly double the score of Queen City, 280 to 148 with just under 14 minutes to go. And it is looking like this is going to be No Coast game to lose.
And a timeout will be taken here. It stops the clock at 13:52, and it will be taken by the Lake Effect Furies.
If you're tweeting about the playoffs, don't forget the hashtag WFTVA playoffs. Also, you can talk to us by using the hashtag Talk2. That's the number 2, WFTDA.
I'm going to challenge the Twitterverse out there. We want to know who you think will win our other semifinal coming up in just a little while between the second-seeded Angel City and the third-seeded Minnesota Roller Girls. That one comes up at 8 o'clock Central. And, of course, one more team will earn their spot to St. Paul, Minnesota in November. Gotham earned their trip earlier today. And one will join the defending Hydra Cup champions later on this evening. Don't forget, third-place game coming up tomorrow afternoon here on WFTDA.TV.
Now, the last four jams have had No Coast outscore Queen City 50-0. And I have to agree with 40-ounce Bounce, who talked to us on Talk to WFTDA, who said she expected this mount to be a lot closer. I think a lot of us did.
We sure did. And I think we're really getting to see what No Coast is all about. I had a chance to watch this team earlier in this year at the Skate the Thrill Invitational, a couple of bouts against St. Chuck's Derby Chicks. This team has gotten much progressively better as this year has progressed. And you know they're going to be making a hard charge in the upcoming rankings when their next release. And it's going to be Flash Gloria as your lead jammer for the Mad Maxines. Librolian donning the star here for the Lake Effect Furies.
Well, holding the star at least.
Well, holding the star, yeah. She's somewhat donning the star. Maybe soon.
Oh, and she makes it through around the outside. I think that that might have shocked No Coast a little bit. They kind of are looking at each other saying, who was that white-helmeted skater that just passed us there?
Hello, somebody coming on by.
But they didn't lose any points. It was a 5-0 jam for No Coast, bringing them up to 285 points to Queen City's 148. 13 minutes, 10 seconds to go in this game.
Boston, of course, very curious to see how this one plays out. They will be in the fifth place contest tomorrow. The rest of your bracket looks like this, with Toronto and Windy City playing in the ninth place game. Helsinki will face the one that suffers defeat in the contest you're currently watching. It's Chubakma donning the star for No Coast for the first trip at the Fast Girl start line. And it's Ivana Layer out for Queen City. So non-traditional jammers here in this rotation for both squads. I'm going to lay her out, trying to work her way to the outside. Meanwhile, Chubakma being hemmed in as well. So nobody with the advantage yet, already 20 seconds deep into jam number 11. 12 and a half minutes left to go in regulation. Layer out, pushing. The pace really slowing down here with the tough walls being set up front. And you can see the hard work here by Queen City doing a number here on Chubakma. Meanwhile, three wall in front doing a nice job on Ivana Layer out.
Yeah, No Coast feeling pretty safe. They can send out a non-traditional jammer like this. Queen City kind of feeling desperate. They need to send out a non-traditional jammer.
Yeah, especially when you're starting to lose the numbers due to penalties here. Bikini Wax now with six trips to the box as well. And she'll be joined by Low Hits Griffin, who takes a trip. It is going to be Chubakma as your lead jammer for No Coast, and that chewed up a lot of time as there's already a minute gone here in jam number 11. And Chubakma looks to be getting around turn number four with one to beat, and it looks like we kind of saw that going to be sent out on a play hit, and it's going to be a power jam here forthcoming for Ivana Layerout.
Ivana Layerout just noticing, I think, that's the situation. She was kind of taking her sweet time to get to the back of the pack, but now she is really making a go for it, and it's a very, very tough one. She's going at help of one blocker versus four blockers for Nokos. As a jailbreak happens and the Queen City pack refills.
This has been an exhausting jam already that's got 10 seconds left to go into it. Now think about your blocking that has to convert over into a power jam kill. But it has been successful here as we reach the conclusion of jam number 11, and it looks like 5 points was notched up there by Nokos. Nothing accumulated there by Queen City. So give credit where credit is due. It's the front walls up front making things happen right now. Nokos sports the 290 to 148 lead, 10:40 left in period two.
The WFTDA recognized tournaments program supports high quality tournaments hosted by WFTDA members worldwide. If your league is hosting a tournament this year, you can learn more about this program and apply at WFTDA.com/events.
That's John Manding. I'm Muckety Muck. Thank you for joining us here on WFTDA.tv. Winner of this one goes on to fifth place. One suffers defeat, falls into the seventh place game. It's Animaniac for Nokos, Murphy for Queen City. 10-10 left to go in the conclusion of this contest. Nobody with the advantage yet until finally getting to the front of the pack. It is Murphy for Queen City. Meanwhile, being hemmed in, looking to star stash here, and with the star in her hand, and now finally giving it off, it will be Reach Porter. Now Donnie Star and Rhinestone Rage is actually going to have to take a seat into the penalty box. So now a power jam for Murphy and Queen City.
A blocker as well in the penalty box for the folks in Room No Coast. Full complement of skaters on Queen City. They should be able to get a little something done here as they push through, but actually having trouble. But eventually does make it through, picks up 5 points, five well-needed points for Queen City. Total of 10 this jam alone. This breaks a seven jam Queen City scoring drought. And that just speaks to the amazing defense that Nokos has shown this game.
Third scoring pass here for Queen City as Murphy, as you get a good look at it. Those tough, tough defensive move sets there in front by Nokos. The Mad Max scenes have come to play in this one, and they have made a count when it really, really counts here on the power jams. As Murphy tries to reset the situation. Meanwhile, it is Rhinestone Rage who did receive the star. Trying to get back into the mix here for Nokos. 10 seconds left to go in this jam. And when it was all said and done, Queen City does tighten up the differential a little bit. But time becoming a factor now with 8:25 left to go here in period number two. Looks like an additional five picked up here by the Lake Effect Furies.
15-point jam. Yeah. Now I want to take a moment here and acknowledge the fact that I have not acknowledged one of the Noco skaters that has been doing just amazing yeoman's work out here. Broken Hearts.
Yes.
Always seems to be just everywhere. She doesn't do the big hits. Mm-hmm. She's always helping out a player. She's not getting any glory for herself. And you just kind of notice her. And that's what I just kind of was taking notes and noticing that I had written her down a couple times. And she's just been doing fantastic. A great addition to this team.
Oh, my. And right from the get-go, Librarian is going to have to go to the Derby Supply penalty box. So Wenton to put the exclamation point on this contest. Here is Slam Anderson, who will be your lead jammer for Nokos. So Librarian sitting in the Derby Supply penalty box, and Slam Anderson full speed ahead with Nokos blocking in front. She will lose one in the process. So a one blocker advantage here for Queen City. And now it looks like this jam will be called off by Anderson. So we look at the clock down below, and we see Nokos sporting the 294 to 163 lead. Nokos rolling along. Big, big scoring stretches here in the second period of play, shutting out Queen City for about 8 minutes worth of clock time.
Flash Gloria on the Fast Girl start line on her lonesome. Corver Librarian is standing in the Derby Supply penalty box, meaning that she has 10 seconds or fewer remaining in her penalty.
Flash Gloria, who has 88 points in this contest, and that does not lead scoring here for Nokos, donning the star. Meanwhile, Librarian back into the mix here for Queen City, and Librarian on the outside finds some open room and is your lead jammer here for Queen City.
Out of the box and straight through. Nice move by Librarian. around the outside, and this time around the inside, picking up a quick 5 points for Queen City.
Boom, boom, just like that with two passes. And now looking for the second scoring pass is Librolian. Works to the outside, ducks down low. Nice work in front there by Winkler. But it will be a five more collected by Librolian, so 10 points on this collection so far. I have a feeling that Queen City will keep this jam going regardless. It is, looks like it will be the star.
Stash once again. They're trying to fool us, but we figured it out most of the time. Splash Gloria.
And this jam will be called off. An additional point collected by Queen City. Two notched up by Noka. So the 11-2 rotation that favors Queen City makes our score 296 to 174 Noka with the advantage over Queen City. And a timeout is taken by Noka with 5:43 left to go in our second period.
You know when you install software on your computer and it just zooms along for quite a while, and then you have the last little bit, and it seems to take forever. That's what these last few points before the triple century mark, before that 300, has seemed like for Nokos. They got up here, everybody's getting super excited, and then Queen City somehow turned, got some defense, slowed them down a little bit. They're not. I don't think they're thinking that that they're going to stop them from getting 300, but I know that's definitely a goal in these last 5 minutes, 44 seconds. Nokos at 296 points. Taking their second-to-last timeout. Queen City also with one timeout remaining, 174 points. Both teams have their official review remaining.
We were looking at Nokos earlier today, John, you and I at trackside, and watching the explosive offensive outburst that Nokos had in the latter stretches of that contest versus Windy City. We thought, you know, this might be a team that might score 300 points. They got the total up to 299 as the game concluded, but a point adjustment after the fact finally pushed them into that 300-point mark. And now we're about to see it twice in one day by the Mad Maxines.
You know, exactly 300 points would be great bookends for this day,
yes,
for them.
Absolutely. And it looks like it will be attained possibly as Chewbacman will be your lead jammer here for Gnocco. 5.5 minutes left to go in regulation.
Low hits Griffin also making it through.
So now both jammers looking for a scoring pass as Chewbacman works to the outside for to the back, and it looks like this jam will be called off. Looks like 2 points will be notched up by Queen City, and waiting for official confirmation from our jammer ref.
Two more.
Two stalemates.
298 points for Noco, 176 for Queen City.
Of course, don't forget, semifinal action coming up at 8 o'clock tonight. You'll want to watch this one, my friends. Minnesota versus Angel City. The winner of that one earns a spot to St. Paul. The one that suffers defeat will face Montreal in the third-place game. That one's going to be, oh, so much fun. It's Animaniac for Nokos. It's Murphy for Queen City. As time now reaches the 4:30 mark left in period number two. Animaniac trying to work their way to the outside. Nothing given yet. Tough walls in front by both squads as Murphy pushing, and boy, take a snapshot of this by Nokos. This is pretty much the narrative of this game, just shutting down all kinds of offense here by Queen City in this contest.
But Queen City continuing to push like a strongman contest.
Mm-hmm.
A big, tough black back wall that she's trying to get through. Animaniac takes lead jam, however, for Nokos.
Murphy still trying to get through on the initial pass. Good teamwork up front there by the Mad Maxines. It will send, however, the pivot as Porter will take a seat. More whistles being assessed. We're giving close watch. We'll send a Queen City blocker to the box. Meanwhile, Animaniac gets on through and gets on by for the grand slam.
And the star pass taking place right now. Pepper Sticks once again taking that jammer star from Murphy for Queen City. And coming up on the back of the pack.
Trying to split the wickets and getting on through. And at the very end there, it will be the back block called on Pepper Sticks.
I don't know about that one. I saw her hit a shoulder, but refs have probably a better view than me. 5 points for Nokos. And that 10-point jam brought them over the triple century mark. Finally, 308 points. Queen City picked up two for 178. 3 minutes remaining in this game.
You can feel it on the side of Nokos. They know that they have this one in full control with this solid play here in the second period. Another second period explosion offensively here by the Mad Maxines as Slam Anderson is your lead jammer. by the Mad Maxines, already with 101 points on the board. That tally will skyrocket on this power jam here.
Rhinestone Rage out of the penalty box, followed closely by number 82, Tuesday Hula from Queen City.
As Anderson meeting the three wall, sent down to the knees. But will reassess the situation, push the way forward, and spins around and gets on front. So it will be the Grand Slam collected by Slam Anderson.
Grand Slam Anderson.
How about that? 45 seconds deep into jam number 17. No Coast on a roll here in the second period. Pepper Sticks looking for points herself. Anderson getting some instruction here from No Coast. They want to kill the clock. Period clock now under 2 minutes. A minute flat left here in jam number 17. More whistles being assessed. And this will lead to another penalty, I do believe, on Queen City. Anderson with another scoring pass here. Meanwhile, Pepper Sticks collects four for Queen City. And Anderson will call off the jam. The final tally, an additional three. So it's a 12-4 strike by No Coast. And they're a minute and a half away from reaching the fifth place game.
And the communication between Slam Anderson and her coaches was basically, should I call it off?
Yeah.
As in the motioning toward her hips. And her coach is saying, yeah, call it up. Well, wait. And then they shrug. And they said, you know, we're ahead by 140 points. Just go ahead and do whatever you want.
When it's been such a solid output from not only Anderson, but everybody involved here from No Coast, pretty much it was a team effort. You can say, yep, you can call it as you see it in the latter stretches of this one. And Flash Gloria will be your lead jammer for a No Coast. Limberalian escapes from the pack as well for Queen City. No Coast coming in as the number 10 team, the 10th seeded team. Whoa, as Limberalian, a double jump almost there and gets through for 4 points.
And it's lucky you can't backblock your own player.
Wow. As Gloria also gets through for 4 points.
And with 35 seconds remaining, she does call it off. So we're going to have a chance for one final jam. Both teams are at full strength now. That Derby Supply penalty box is empty.
Well, the fans from Nebraska that have come to follow the state team here of No Coast have been entertained by not one, but two 300-point performances here.
And what I think is really funny is all of the No Coast fans are on the side of the arena with the cameras.
Yeah, they're away
so
from the hard
you're
camera.
Not actually seeing.
We're going to fix that tomorrow. We are going to fix that. If I have to stand in front of Ralston Arena and file everybody
like,
single
get
file
on the
into
side that
side,
you want to, yeah.
We should just get out the caution tape and just mark off all those seats right now. Put a big giant tarp on the south side of the arena here. You gotta look at Queen City.
It's a shorter walk.
Yeah, that's right. Queen City, you know what? Spirited play here in this contest here, and they've got a tough one against Helsinki tomorrow. But you gotta like the spirit and the drive and the determination and the desire. 186 points here in a losing cause is still very, very productive for Queen City, so they can use this momentum and these streaks that they've had offensively here this weekend to go against a hard-charging Helsinki squad. We have ourselves a team timeout being taken here.
And they really got beat up by Gotham last night that very, very hard-fought last jam win against Toronto, a team they had never beaten before. So they were on a high, and then all of a sudden they're against Gotham, and a 600-point game scored by Gotham to about, what was that final total? 590 Gotham, 29 for Queen City. So that has got to be exhausting.
But they can turn it around on Sunday as this last jam gets underway. It's going to be Animaniac of No Coast, Limberalian of Queen City. So No Coast wanting to put the finishing touches on a very successful Saturday as Animaniac tries to push her way to the front of the pack and will get on through. That great second and third effort from the No Coast jammers have been a telling tale in this one. Of course, the blocking has been oh so superb. So we'll see if Animaniac can, with a skip and calls it off.
Yeah, Animaniac that time, she looked at her coaches. Coaches said call it off after it had gone to zero. She said, you know what, I want to try one more thing. Picked up 5 points, bringing No Coast's unofficial final right now to 329. Queen City with 186. The refs are over at the scoreboard, making sure everything is copacetic. And that will be our final score.
Well, the story, and there's numerous ones to follow this weekend here as we get the official confirmation now. This is your official final with NoCoast winning. The narrative, and one of plenty that we followed this weekend, the incredible trajectory upwards of the NoCoast Mad Maxines. And they have notched up two solid victories here on a Saturday in their home state, and they came into this tournament as the number 10 seed, but now tomorrow they have a chance to finish this weekend in fifth place. This would be an incredible jump. They've got Boston tomorrow and what's going to be a really solid contest, and if they have the type of games or game tomorrow that we saw in both their games today, fifth place is easily attainable.
Oh, absolutely. And again, that's a raise from where they came in.
Big,
that's a victory. That's a victory. When you come here and you take on some very, very tough opponents, you don't know precisely where you are going to end up. And they've ended up increasing their number, heading on up, and getting closer to that number one position. But that number one position is going to be held by either Gotham or the winner of the next game, Minnesota versus Angel City.
We'll talk about this one here in just a second. So if you're following NoCoast, we will see you in the fifth place game. That takes place tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock Central. And if you're following Queen City, still an opportunity to end on a high note against Helsinki. That will take place at 12 noon. So adjust your clocks accordingly, depending on where you're living. But I think both squads very happy to be in that seventh place bout tomorrow.
Yeah,
Helsinki
absolutely.
Coming in as the number seven seed. They can leave in the same position. And, of course, with Queen City coming in as the number nine, a huge jump up for them. So a nice solid weekend considering all the mayhem that we had here in this consolation bracket.
Yeah, I mean, NoCoast coming in at 10, having the ability to be the five finisher is going to be a very, very, they've got to be excited about that, and especially in this hometown crowd.
You know what I'm excited about?
Close to hometown.
The next game that's upcoming.
Absolutely.
Number two versus number three with Angel City versus Minnesota. I think you and I might have to go to the back and just kind of get all antsy because we know coming into this one that if your brackets played the way that they were going to in the quarterfinal round, that was going to be the matchup in the semifinals. You will see that one and you'll want to stick around for that great contest. Speaking of great contest, Slam Anderson was such a great individual effort, aided by some solid blocking up front. I think it's only apropos that Miguel Gorilla should talk to Slam Anderson at trackside.
Take it away, Miguel.
Miguel Gorilla here, trackside with some excited NoCoast fans. They are wrecking cities like Godzilla. Windy City loses today. Queen City loses today to them. I'm with Slam Anderson. Slam, I have to ask you a question before we do any of this stuff. You guys changed your ways from government names to the derby names. Why is that? Was there a reason for that?
Because our fans didn't like it. Okay. You know, they wanted to still call us by our derby names, and that's cool.
That goes to my next question. What does it feel like to play here in Nebraska, in your home state, with such great fan support?
It's awesome. We have the most amazing fans in the world. They travel really well. They had a tailgate yesterday. I mean, our fans are amazing.
Is it extra energy? Do you guys feel that extra buzz when the crowd goes wild like that?
Yeah, wouldn't you?
I would, for sure. I'm feeling it as a fan watching. 113 points in this game for you. The 10 seed right now going to play for the 5th seed tomorrow. That's an amazing turnaround. That's a story that everyone's going to be talking about. Why is your team playing so well this weekend?
Because we're playing our own game. We're doing what we went out there and trained to do, and we're just executing. I mean, that's what it's all about. You practice every day, and you go out, and you do your job, and that's it.
That's all that needs to be said. These scores are speaking for themselves. Slam Anderson celebrating right now with her team. She gets to play tomorrow for fifth place. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
Congratulations on a great run today, okay? We are not done with WFTDA-TV. That's right. We got one more contest, the next semifinal. Number two, Angel City. Number three, Minnesota. Stay tuned.